the hare is down. Here is the kind of retrieve that takes months of careful work to achieve. And here is top Gundog trainer Ricky Moloney to explain how to achieve it.
What you're seeing there is you're actually seeing dogs, open dogs, that have been trained to a high level. On a shooting day, would you be sending dogs those distances? Probably not. But the reason that we're training dogs to go those distances is if we get birds that are playing down a long way, by the time you've walked over, that bird's made good its escape. The quicker you can get a dog to the fall with as little disturbance as possible, hopefully, the quicker you're going to put that game in the bag. So it was of no benefit, that retrieve, to my dogs. So what I did was offered it over to another one of the dog handlers. He sent his dog, really it is a straight line, every retrieve is a straight line. He sent his dog up, got it up onto the rise. Dog started just to cast, a little bit of whistling, a little bit of handling, pushed the dog back. It's teaching that dog that if it believes the handler, it's gonna get success. Dogs don't understand distance. I think a dog doesn't understand how far something is. Back means go back. Left means left and right means right. So if you limit your dog's training to only ever doing 30 odd retrieves, that becomes the norm. If you're stretching that dog and once it can do 30 yards, putting it then to 50 yards and then 70 yards and building it up, before long the dog doesn't think about distance. You give it a line and it morphs out until you either tell it that that's the area or it finds it itself.
Ricky Moloney runs Ribblesdale Labradors. This series on Gundog training tips is brought to you by Skinner's Pet Foods, maker of the Field and Trial range of Gundog feeds. Visit skinnerspetfoods.co.uk.